Crazy Weekend by Gary Soto, narrated by Anthony Perez.
Chapter 1. Hector Beltran and his carnal, Mando Tafoya, both seventh graders from East Los Angeles, stepped off the train. Each held a suitcase in one hand, and their shoulders were weighed down with backpacks. It was February, cold, and fog had smothered Fresno like a white shroud. Fog hung between the telephone lines and over parked cars and trucks. Fog dimmed the traffic lights. Fog blew down the empty streets of the Santa Fe Depot. Fog lived in the very bones of each passenger who stepped off the train. "Hace mucho frío," Mando said as he dropped his suitcases and rubbed his cold hands. He was tall for a boy of 13, with hair the color of wet coal. "Where's your tío?" "No sé," Hector said, straining to see through the fog. He put down his suitcase and breathed into his hands, which were pink as the underside of a starfish. Like Mando, he was tall, with thick black hair. And beneath his clothes, his body was hardened with muscle from playing sports, mostly soccer. The two boys had been sent to Fresno for a three-day weekend, an idea spawned by Hector's mother, who said they should see another part of the world.
"You and Mando should travel,"
Hector's mother suggested one night when she saw that they were so bored they were counting the hairs on their knuckles and arguing about who had more. Hector had imagined Paris or Madrid, and Mando had imagined Acapulco, where he could take a blow-up raft and ride the large white-tipped waves until they sputtered into fingers of foam. They saw themselves sporting sunglasses propped on their heads. They saw themselves asking for directions and then giving directions. They saw themselves eating in fancy restaurants with white napkins under their chins. That was in October, when a few herds of leaves were scuttling through the streets in East Los. Now it was February, and they were standing like two lone birds at the train station, waiting for Hector's uncle, Julio, a photographer. Hector hadn't seen him in 2 years, since the time Uncle Julio visited and treated them to Disneyland. Later, they rented two surfboards to crack the waves at Malibu Beach. Neither of them was any good at surfing, but the crashing waves worked up an appetite that was solved by a huge dinner on Olvera Street. Hector and Mando were looking nervously at each other, wondering if anyone would pick them up when they heard through the fog,
"Hey, you little vatos!"
Hector and Mando turned to see a man approach them with two cameras hanging on his shoulders. He was tall, mustached, and walking with a cane. He had a kind face and was dressed casually in khakis and an overcoat. He resembled a detective, rumpled and a bit worn.
"You've grown,"
Uncle Julio said, ruffling Hector's hair. "It's mom's cooking," Hector said with a smile. "What happened to your leg?"
"I fell out of an airplane."
He hooked the cane in the crook of his arm and gave his nephew a hug.
"An airplane?" Hector said with surprise. "The airplane was parked on the ground, and lucky for me, because I wasn't wearing a parachute."
He shrugged one of the cameras off his shoulder and took off the lens cap.
"This is your amigo Mando."
"Yeah, this is Mando."
"Hey, Mando, welcome," the uncle said.
They shook hands. Raza style.
"Mucho gusto, Mr. Silva. Me and Hector are glad you're gonna let us stay with you."
"No problem. Call me Julio, Mando," Uncle said.
He raised one of his cameras to his eye and snapped the shutter. The lens blinked at them three times before Uncle capped the lens and shrugged the camera back onto his shoulder. He took his suitcase from Hector.
"So how was the trip?"
"Long," Hector answered. "We saw nothing but fog."
"We saw a crash," Mando interrupted.
"Nah, Mando, the guy was just parked weird."
"Nah, I saw his front fender. It was all smashed up."
"That was an old wreck. You need glasses."
"You're the one that needs glasses."
The two argued as they left the train station. They got into Uncle's Ford Escort station wagon and cooled their argument as the car started through the fog that would claim Fresno until a wind blew it away, or a cloud let loose its cargo of rain.
"You still taking pictures, Uncle?"
Hector asked after a while. A cold shudder ran up Hector's back as a car's warm air stirred among them. When Julio was in the Air Force, he had learned photography. He kept busy snapping pictures of generals and colonels and wreckage of jets that went down, mostly from mechanical problems, but sometimes from pilot error. After he got out of the service, he worked in Los Angeles for a popular magazine. He decided to move from LA when the smog and traffic worked on his nerves. He was also being pestered by an old girlfriend and the girlfriend's new boyfriend, a man with tattoos of snakes that slithered down his arm.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.